Dumbbells, today we are doing the ultimate ab workout. We are using a set of dumbbells. I'm using a 5-pound set of dumbbells, but you can use what works for you, maybe a 3-pound set for a little bit lighter, or maybe even up to like 8 pounds. So do what works for you. Again, I'm starting with 5. We are gonna start with a little warm up and then we'll get into our exercises. All right, so we're gonna do a bear plank today. So a little different than our regular plank, you're gonna have your knees bent here. So hands are gonna go right underneath your shoulders and then knees are right underneath your hips. You're gonna tuck the toes under just like you would for a regular plank. We're gonna hold it for 30 seconds here. So when you're ready, you keep those toes tucked under and just lift those knees like an inch off of the floor and hold it there. Big inhales, long exhales. Keep the shoulders right over those hands. Keep those hips lifted, scoop the belly in deeper, draw that navel towards your spine, knit the rib cage together, pull that corset nice and tight, finding that waistline there. Breathing deep, lifting through those shoulder blades. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now drop the knees down, pull right back up. Down and lift. So just about an inch or two. Don't lift too high, just about shoulder height. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and down. Shake it out a little bit. Roll out those shoulders. They seem like they wouldn't be too hard, but they are challenging, right? All right, we're gonna go into that bear plank again and just do shoulder taps side to side here, 10 on each side. All right, so holding that same position again, same spot with those knees, you're gonna lift it up and hold it. Right here, you tap the shoulder, switch, 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 just 10 each side. The goal here is to stay steady through the rest of the body. Find that stability. 3, 2, one more each side. And down. Whew. All right, let's get into our workout. We're gonna start with just one single dumbbell for the first few exercises. So grab one, lay all the way back, and we're gonna start with those legs nice and long. And then from here, arms straight up towards the sky. Now, naturally, you're probably gonna have a little space in that low back. What I want you to do here is scoop the belly, flatten that back all the way down towards the mat so you're already engaged before we even get going. And then from here, lift it up into a little curl, down, lift and down, lift and down. So it doesn't have to be big. Keep those arms in line with the shoulders. And just remember, if any of these exercises don't feel quite right with the dumbbell, you can totally just get rid of it. It's there to create a little extra resistance for you. Draw those abs in tighter for 3 more. 2. Last one. And rest. Whew. All right, bring those legs all the way up to the sky. If you need to keep a bent knee position for this, again, totally fine. All the way up to the sky. Now from here, you press it up, up, just increasing that challenge a little more. Belly flat. You've got this. Staying strong through those abs. Pressing that weight up, flattening that belly each and every time. 3 more. You can do it. Last one. And rest. Okay, now we are going to kind of increase it that much more. Legs are gonna go down into a leg lower. Arms are gonna reach overhead. They don't have to go super far back, as much as you can control. Once you start to feel like those shoulders can't control it anymore, don't go any farther down. So it might just be up to here. It might be a little lower if you're stronger. Now, they're all gonna come together, all gonna go apart. Are you ready? Let's go. Legs up, curl it up. Now from here, extend over and up, over, up. But again, keeping that low back glued to the mat the whole time. If you need to, head can stay down.
If you need a little neck break, that's totally fine. Just remember to imprint that low back to the mat. For five, belly flat. For four, three more. Two, last one. And rest. Oh my gosh, those are killer. Okay, we are still having just one weight for this next exercise here. We are gonna do alternating leg lowers, holding one weight straight up to the sky, the other arm is gonna be out to the side. So, taking it down just a notch after that last exercise. Weight is going straight up into the sky. Right now I have it in my left hand. My right arm is gonna go out to the side. Try not to let it go onto the mat, but if you need to, it can totally do that too. It's gonna stay lifted. Now, you're going to lift, if you can, into an ab curl and hold that ab curl the whole time. If you can't, keep the head down, totally fine. Legs straight up to the sky. Drop one leg down, up, and switch. Down and lift. Down. You'll feel a little bit of extra obliques helping keep you steady. Abs are super strong. Draw them a little deeper. Three more each side. Two more each side. Come on, stay strong. Last one each side. And rest. Oh my gosh. All right, get ourselves situated for that next side. Arms straight up to the sky. If you need to, you could always bring your hand behind your head too for a little extra support for your neck. That's totally fine. It will create a little bit more of an imbalance side to side though, because that arm out to the side is gonna help you maintain a little bit of stability through that center since we're uneven. But it is an option if you need it. Legs straight up to the sky, arm out to the side. Lift into that ab curl, here we go. You drop, up, switch. Drop, up, switch. So again, here's that variation if you need that hand behind the head, but again, it will increase that stability challenge side to side. We'll make those obliques work a little harder. Two more. One more each side. Come on, stay strong. And rest. Oh my goodness, those are challenging. Okay, we're gonna grab our weight, hold on to each end with both hands. Now, little double leg stretch here. So we're gonna reach the legs out to 45 degrees, pull them in and pull the arms in towards those knees, kind of similar to that double leg stretch that we were, the double leg lower we were doing before. So arms again are gonna be reaching overhead, legs are gonna be reaching out long. So from here, start up, you're kind of curled together. Now extend the arms, extend the legs, pull it in. Reach, pull it in. Reach, in. Belly flat the whole time. Again, feel free to lower the head if you need a little rest for that neck. It can be a lot today. Pull it in. Reach, pull it in. Reach, in. Just for four, we're gonna add a little twist. In three, two, one. Now, you're gonna extend it out, come up, twist to one side, out, twist to the other side. Reach, twist, reach, twist. Lengthening out, pulling in, twisting, finding those obliques. Stay strong, ladies. Again, you can always lower the head if you need it. In the center, come up and twist. So close, ladies, we are almost done. Twisting, three more each side. Two. My abs are on fire. Last one each side. And rest. Oh my goodness. Okay. grabbing our weight. We're gonna come into some planks here. All right, so we have our weights. We're gonna be holding a plank on our hands. We're gonna slide one weight over to the, both weights actually. We're gonna slide one weight at a time over to the opposite side. Grab the next one, slide it over. So slide it, switch. Slide it, switch. You ready? All right, so I'm gonna start with the weights towards you. We're gonna have our hands just in front of it, just a little bit there. We're gonna find that nice, beautiful plank position. If you need a little extra stability today, you can have your feet a little bit wider, about mat width apart, to help you from wiggling those hips side to side. Or you could even do this one on your knees. Just make sure you have a beautiful, beautiful plank position from your head to your knees or all the way down to those toes. All right, so finding that plank position, hold it steady, pull, 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 pull. Working on that stability again. Staying strong. This one's gonna get that heart rate up like crazy. Core strong. Working on that stability. Three more each side. Pull, 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 pull. Two more each side. One more each side. Pull, pull, and down. Whew. Oh my gosh, okay. Now, last one we're gonna do here. A little bit of arm work sneaking in there, because you know I love sneaking in a little extra. We're gonna do full renegade rows, which means we're in a plank, we row it up, send all the way up to the sky, all the way down, switch sides, all the way up to the sky, and down. So we're gonna find like a side plank position when that weight is all the way up to the sky. Last exercise here, I know you can do it. Let's get right into it. Here we go. So the weights are gonna be right underneath those shoulders. Again, find that wide position with those feet for a little extra stability here today. Here we go, find that plank. And now we row it up, extend all the way down, switch. Just 10 on each side to finish. You kind of punch that weight up to the sky, finding that beautiful side plank. Kind of swiveling those feet side to side here, staying lifted in that oblique on that bottom side. Beautiful ladies. Four more each side, press. Press. Three more each side. Stay strong with me. No locked out arm on the bottom. Two more each side. Last set right here. And down, oh my gosh, almost lost that last one right there. Oh my gosh, okay, let's stretch it out. Awesome, awesome job today. Put those weights off to the side. Let's take a little cobra stretch. Stretch out those abs. Whew, they deserve it. My abs are on fire right now. All right, so elbows right underneath the shoulders. Lift into a nice, beautiful cobra. Remember, your core still should be engaged here. You're still scooping that belly in, drawing that navel towards your waistline, engaging and pulling those ribs together. It's gonna help protect that low back. It might limit your range of motion a little bit, but it will actually increase your stretch more, believe it or not. Again, if you're super strong or super flexible, you can always lift those arms up a little straighter. Just make sure you don't feel any crunching in that low back. Scoop the belly. Lengthen out through the chest, through the crown of the head. Nice job, ladies. Sit back into a little child's pose. Let that low back release. Take a breath here one more time.
And then if you are comfortable kneeling, you can stay right down here. Otherwise, you can stand up. You're gonna bring your arms up, grab onto one wrist, reach it over to the side, get a nice little side bend, stretch for those obliques. Bring it up through the center, switch sides. Bring it up. And you ladies are all done. Amazing job. Get those abs working. I will see you in the next workout.